Hi, I'm Whitney Espich, the CEO of the MIT Alumni Association, and I hope you enjoy this digital production created for alumni and friends like you. Good morning, everybody. I'm Whitney Espich, Chief Executive Officer of the MIT Alumni Association, and it's so great to see you again this morning. I've seen many of you over the course of sunny yesterday. Without further ado, I am privileged to welcome to speak for his last Tech Day as MIT President, L. Rafael Reif. He's in here right now. Let's give him a round of applause right now. I'm going to say a few more words about you, so hold tight. Since 2012, Rafael has spearheaded the development of open online learning platforms, MITx and edX, and has led MIT's pioneering efforts to help redefine the future of higher education. He has led the redevelopment of Kendall Square. Many of you have seen the results of that on your visits today, putting us on the map as a world-renowned hub for biotech and innovation. In 2018, he announced the MIT Schwarzman College of Computing to bring computing to all academic disciplines, the most significant reshaping of MIT since the 1950s. President Reif has mobilized MIT to make an impact on climate change, introducing major initiatives including Fast Forward, MIT's Climate Action Plan for the Decade, and recently, the Climate Grand Challenges. And this is just a sampling of what he has done over the past 10 years. President Reif started out at the Institute in 1980 as Professor Reif, and later became Provost Reif. In several roles and in many different ways, he has helped advance MIT's mission to make a better world. Thank you, President Reif, for making time out of this very busy weekend at MIT, what with the special celebration of the 2020s and 2021s about to happen on Killian Court. We appreciate your joining us for a few brief moments. And now, President Rafael Reif.
Thank you, Whitney, for the introduction, for your thoughtful leadership, and for your wonderful example always of generous collaboration. I assume you can hear me well in the back. Can you hear me? No. Can you hear me now? I said thank you, Whitney, a few minutes ago. Special thanks also to the alumni and volunteers who took on the monumental job of organizing this terrific weekend and bringing us together as a community. And a quick shout out, I don't see too many of them, but I think I saw some coming in, to the members of the classes of 2020 and 2021. I know that many of you on those classes attended the senior ball last night, because I see quite a few of you, and you must be a little tired this morning, but I'm delighted that you're here, those of you who are, and that you are finally able to enjoy this MIT tradition. And as I saw you last night, you certainly had plenty of time to decide what to wear. I'm told we have more than 13,000 people attending this weekend. This is quite an amazing turnout. But I don't believe it should be a surprise. The love that all of you have for the Institute and for each other was suppressed for a long time. And now it's coming, flooding back. This year, we have guests from all 50 states, plus Washington, D.C., from 76 countries, and from 42 different course majors. I myself didn't remember that we had so many course majors. I know that years from now, when I reflect on my time as MIT's president, I will remember, and I feel it in my skin right now, the thrill of being reunited with all of you today. It's an immense privilege to lead a community that has such a deep commitment to the values we all share: excellence, integrity, boldness, curiosity, an open spirit of collaboration, you see some of it this morning, a strong desire to make a positive impact, and a sense of responsibility to make a better world. In fact, one of the most or small consolations of the last 2 years has been the realization that even a global pandemic could not stop the people of MIT. Let me give you one example. MIT's research community has been taking on climate change for many years through hands-on problem solving, insightful analysis, and a commitment to making a better planet Earth. But the urgency of the climate crisis continues and continues to demand new solutions and immediate impact. So in 2020, MIT launched the Climate Grand Challenges, inviting faculty and researchers to share their boldest ideas to address the most complex climate problems. And nearly 400 of them responded. It wasn't easy, but from about 100 proposals, we selected 5 extremely promising projects. They will receive the funding and support to rapidly develop their ideas and scale practical solutions. Another example, the Institute has tremendous strength in design. The School of Architecture and Planning offers courses that we might call Design Plus. Design Plus Computing, Design Plus Biology, Design Plus Arts. Students across majors want access to design tools and strategies. That is clear from the popularity of MIT's new design minor. In the fall of 2020, a group of faculty got together and came up with a way to bring insight from design thinking to all 5 schools and the college. They then asked additional faculty, staff, and students to help further shape the concept. And the result was the MIT Morningside Academy for Design. As a major interdisciplinary center, the Academy will usher in a transformative new research agenda and further enhance MIT's ability to help solve society's urgent problems. These are the kind of efforts that managed to flourish despite the pandemic here in Cambridge. And I know that all of you were doing the same, taking the spirit out, taking the spirit of MIT out into the world and making the world better. In fact, you did so much that we had to come up with a brand new way of recognizing outstanding contributions, the MIT Better World Alumni Service Award. You will meet the inaugural recipients soon. We have an excellent program of faculty speakers this morning, one that I am particularly interested in. They will address a topic that is important to everyone, though many of us would rather not think about it too much, and that's aging. Now, aging does not have a terrific reputation. In fact, as a topic, it's usually considered boring and certainly not uplifting. But this is MIT, and we know that any natural phenomenon and any aspect of the human experience can be fascinating if you approach it with the MIT spirit of curiosity and problem solving. So our faculty and researchers are looking closely at what happens as we age. They are carrying out bold experiments and asking probing questions. And when we look with fresh eyes at what exactly happens as we age, it becomes extremely interesting, at least to me. Take Joseph Coughlin, director of the MIT Age Lab. His team has developed something called an aging suit. People of any age can put this on and experience the world as a person in their mid-70s. Some of us would rather take our aging suits off, but we don't have a way to do that yet. Dr. Coughlin explains that wearing the suit allows people to experience firsthand the physical challenges of aging, from limited mobility to reduced vision. Having the hands-on awareness inspires students, engineers, and designers to develop services and products to improve quality of life for older adults. For younger adults, whose understanding of aging may be a bit abstract, it can inspire deep insight and empathy. But of course, aging is about more than physical changes. Most of us have given some thought to maintaining our ability to learn and to remember as we age. Pioneering neuroscientist Li Wei Tsai may be able to help with that. When Professor Tsai came to MIT in 2006, she already had an impressive reputation for fundamental research on how the brain works. But once she became immersed in MIT's culture of innovation and impact, she began to recognize that her fundamental neuroscience could potentially translate into a game-changing medical application, specifically a practical treatment for Alzheimer's disease. Professor Tsai collaborated with Professor Ed Boyden, an expert in the field of optogenetics, and together they made an incredible discovery, a way to stimulate brain waves using light and sound, which has the potential to delay the onset of Alzheimer's disease. This discovery has taken research on brain disorders in a totally new direction. And Professor Tsai will tell you more about that in a moment. This is the kind of groundbreaking research on aging and longevity that is happening across MIT. In the traditional fields that you might expect, like neuroscience and biology and genetics, but also in some fields that you might not expect, like economics, artificial intelligence, and urban planning. As we all know, one of MIT's greatest strengths is our interdisciplinary approach to big, important, complex problems, problems that affect the entire human population. Working together and sharing expertise across disciplines is how we can best serve humanity and help guide society toward a better and brighter future. Today's program will reveal this service in action. So I will let now our remarkable faculty take it from here. On a personal note, I want to thank you for your encouragement and support during the last 10 years. And I wish you a wonderful reunion weekend. Thank you.
Thanks for joining us. And for more information on how to connect with the MIT Alumni Association, please visit our website.